G'day guys, Lemon Eating Cow here, and today I am making a video, something a little bit different. I just thought I'd give you an update of what's going on with the channel, kind of what's going on with me a little bit, and where I kind of see the channel going in the future, or where I wanted it to go in the future. I wasn't originally going to make this video until a lot further down the track, but recent happenings have kind of forced my hand a little bit. But it's also New Year's Eve, so I thought, well, New Year's Eve here in Australia, so I thought, why not make the video now? And then it kind of gives us a little bit of a roadmap going into 2017. So the channel so far has been going absolutely amazing. I think, like, the channel's been going just over 30 days now, I think, and I'm up to about 3,100 subscribers, which is just unbelievable. I never thought it'd get this big. I was saying if I get like 100 subscribers in the first month, I thought, man, I'm doing really well and people are watching my stuff, but I really didn't expect it to blow up so much. And that's due mainly to the kind of hype train that was surrounding Final Fantasy 15. But I like to think that I put in a decent amount of work to my videos. I know they're not perfect, but that's because I'm still learning. I'm terrible at Photoshop. My audio equipment, it could do with a bit of work. There's a few things that I do want to tweak in the future, but I wanted to keep my initial costs and my initial outlays pretty low. So yeah, hopefully as the channel moves forward, we kind of step things up in that regard and maybe work on getting the things a bit more flashy. But yeah, so far your support has been absolutely amazing, and I really appreciate all the not only the kind comments, but you know, if there's a criticism of the way I do things, then that's fine. It needs to be said. Like, I can't really improve if all I hear is positivity. Well, I love the positivity, it's fantastic, but I don't know, I just need open, honest criticism, and then hopefully I can make it not only something better for me, but also something better for you guys, because at the end of the day, you're the ones watching, so it has to be good for you. And in regards to that, I started a series called the my level one capped playthrough of Final Fantasy 15. I got up to the second episode. I was doing them in like an hour block, and these were taking quite a while to encode and then upload. I know you can do things more efficiently. I should have compressed the file sizes more and things like that. But at the moment, like I said, I'm a bit of a noob when it comes to video editing and such. So they were taking up quite a bit of time. And over Christmas, because I was kind of traveling around a lot, I did have a fair few episodes of those on a like a portable hard drive. And now I don't have them. The files got corrupted somehow. The whole hard drive is pretty much stuffed. It's like a 2 terabyte hard drive, and it's pretty much everything's on there is gone. I had wedding photos on there and a few other photos. Luckily, I have other backups of those, but I didn't have backups of the episodes. So what I'm left with now is no episodes, but my save files are probably, I think I'm in like chapter 8 at the moment. So there's 8, 9, 10 hours or something pretty much missing of that playthrough. And at this point, I don't think I can muster the enthusiasm to go back and redo those story that that playthrough. At this point, I'm really sorry if you guys were a fan of that. I know I was a bit ranty and, you know, just kind of running my mouth when I was playing the game, but I was enjoying the speaking aspect of it, but the actual playthrough, not so much. But I'm planning to, when the further DLCs and things like that come out, I'm definitely wanting to go back through the game and maybe we'll check out the new cutscenes and we'll see if the episodes are added in and we'll muck around in the carnival and all that. But at the moment, the level one playthrough or level one cap playthrough is definitely on hold. Yeah, I'm sorry if you're looking forward to the series, but I can't do it at the moment. And I don't really want to force something because I'd feel like I wouldn't put my all into it and it would come across half-assed, and that's really not what I want to do with this. I want to try and keep to a standard. I just don't want to put crap out there to get views, you know? Because I could have used clickbait titles and just complete lies, which I've seen a lot of other channels do with Final Fantasy, but that's not what I want to do. I'm looking towards making this channel a solid fixture in the future if I can. And now, speaking of the future, I originally started this channel. I just wanted to get a few guides out there. In my mind, I was thinking, yeah, I'll do a few guides of Final Fantasy 15. It probably won't get much attention, but a little bit. And then I'll move on to other games and I'll try and do reviews if I can, and just kind of play what I wanted to play or what was popular or whatever was happening and kind of get it out there. And at the moment, it seems like the channel is pretty much a Final Fantasy 15 fixture. I put up a few Resident Evil videos. They didn't get many views, but I didn't really expect them to get that much. I mean, it's quite an old demo, but I just wanted to kind of test out the procedure. But in the future, I don't want to alienate anybody because I know quite a few of you are really big fans of Final Fantasy 15, but I don't want to be a solid Final Fantasy channel. I think there's some incredibly good channels out there at the moment. Namely, for me, number one is Mr. Happy 1227, I think, is the number at the end. Anyway, it's Mr. Happy, and his channel is just amazing. Like all the lore videos he does, and the I think he does a community letter type of format with the Final Fantasy 14, and everything. He's just unrivaled. Like I don't feel like I could add anything to the Final Fantasy narrative if I was to expand my channel into lore discussions and things like that. And quite frankly, I don't know enough about the game and the meta and everything to really talk about it that way. So yeah, in the future, I'm hoping, like in January, I think Kingdom Hearts is coming out. I definitely want to cover Kingdom Hearts 2.8. Final Fantasy, blah. Resident Evil 7 is also coming out. I would really be interested in doing that. I've loved all the other Resident Evil games, so I'm hoping this one is quite good. And also, I think Yakuza 0 is coming out. I wouldn't mind having a look at that. I think they're great fun. Just kind of beat the crap out of people and eat noodles. And yeah, it's great. But as far as Final Fantasy 15 goes, I have bought the season pass, so I'm definitely interested in keeping you updated on the content, the DLC that's coming out. I think we've got five more DLCs to look forward to, the episodes for the boys, one after that, and then I think the last one is the multiplayer DLC, and that's looking pretty cool. So I'm excited about the future content and I think they said they're adding cinematics and all these different things to Final Fantasy 15, which will be fantastic. I'm definitely hoping to catch up on that. But don't think that I'm just going to leave Final Fantasy behind. I'll still update, and when new content comes out, I'll be making videos on that. As far as the scheduling goes for the channel, I've been able to, I think, upload pretty consistently over the past month. And that's definitely due to the fact that I've been off work recently. I injured myself a couple of months ago and I wasn't able to work at all. The doctors wouldn't clear me to work. So about a month into that, I got pretty bored, and that's actually why I started the channel, because I was going crazy. So I need to do something constructive to kind of pass the days. So besides taking care of my daughter and, doing the house, a few things around the house, I've just been making videos. So I think I've been doing two a day, pretty much every day. But I think around about the 15th, I am going into the doctors to get a reevaluation of where I'm at, and I'm thinking they're probably gonna send me back to work, which is good. But I don't really know what's gonna happen with the YouTube channel. I would still love to get out one video a day if I can. that should be pretty obtainable, I think. But I just have to see what's going to go on. And of course, I'll let you guys know what's happening, where I stand in that regard. But I definitely want to make this into something for the future. I would really like for this to be more of a focus. So I'll be doing everything I can to maintain this. And in terms of maintaining it, I also want to make a presence on social media. I have started a Facebook page, which I kind of post when Postal Mega's saying a new video is up and etc. But there's very little engagement there at the moment. I need to get the word out about it and kind of get more people interested. But maybe it's a thing. Do you guys use Twitter more? Is Instagram a good thing for this type of post? I don't know how that aspect works of it in regards to a YouTube channel, but I'm kind of trying to educate myself on it and get caught up. But you guys let me know what platform you use and what you think would be the most convenient way to let you know. I'm in the process of doing the Twitter thing, so yeah, I'll see how it goes over the next month or so. But apart from that, I really just want to say again, your support has been absolutely fantastic. Obviously, I couldn't do any of this without you guys. Making videos is one thing, but seeing those likes and those views and those comments just, it's great. I really like getting up in the morning and I sit down with a coffee and I kind of go over the comments and things like that. I try to answer as much as I can because I really like that fan interaction or fan user interaction, I guess. For me, it's really good and it makes it, I don't know, special, I guess. I really like the interaction there. So, yeah, keep it up. And I'll make sure that I do too. Yeah, I don't think I really wanted to say anything else. But thank you for listening to my ramblings. And I hope 2017 is going to be a fantastic year. So, if you're going out for New Year's, be responsible. Take care of yourself, don't drink and drive, and I really hope that you have a happy New Year's. This has been Lemon Eating Cow. Thank you. Moo.